Menstrual disorders include a number of conditions. Dysmenorrhea is a painful menstrual period. Amenorrhagia is a heavy menstrual period. Oligomenorrhea is infrequent menstrual period. Hypomenorrhea is a scanty or very, very light menstrual period. And premenstrual syndrome is a mood disorder with various symptoms before the menstruation. And amenorrhea is an absent menstrual period for a long time. Normal menstrual cycle include menstrual period or bleeding between 21 to 42 days apart, lasting no longer than 7 days. So anything outside of that is abnormal. So if your periods come every 21 days, it's still okay. If they come every 35 to 42 days, it's also okay. However, if the frequency is less or more, it's abnormal. Irregular periods, such as periods coming at different times, should be checked out to make sure there isn't a condition leading to this, which could be a hormonal or structural or infection. So heaviness of menstrual period is measured in volume, and anything between 80 to 120 mils of blood loss is normal. So we know that a tablespoon is 15 mils. It's very difficult to work out the blood loss, so the easiest way to kind of learn how much blood you're losing is trying to wet the tampon with water to see what is a spoon, how does a spoon of water feels. And this is the same way as a spoon of blood would feel. And we know that it's very easy to over or underestimate the blood loss. If you feel tired, unusually tired, or you feel that your menstrual periods are very heavy, if you're changing your pads or tampons every hour or two, you should see a doctor to be checked to make sure there isn't a condition leading to menorrhagia or heavy menstrual period. And if you don't do so and you do have menorrhagia for a prolonged period of time, you may develop iron deficiency and quite a bad tiredness, anemia, shortness of breath, palpitations. We don't particularly worry about very light periods. If you are worried, you should have a checkup to make sure that your uterus and ovaries are functioning normally. The light periods can be due to contraceptive pill or hormonal treatment that one uses, or it could be genetically light. Some women may have lighter periods as they get older, or it can be opposite and they can get heavier. So regular checkups are important to make sure that everything is in order. So
the causes of menstrual disorders could be medical conditions such as thyroid disease, HIV, blood disorders, thrombophilia. Interestingly, COVID vaccination and COVID infection caused menstrual disorders in 5% of women. So there's sometimes unusual factors that are causing menstrual disorders. Menstrual disorders can be caused by infections, gynecological infections, or sexually transmitted infections such as chlamydia. Menstrual disorders can be caused by fibroids, and they generally lead to heavy and painful periods, and endometriosis and adenomyosis, ovarian cysts, cervical cancer, uterine cancer, and hormonal disorders such as change in hormonal levels in menopause. In pregnancy, we don't have periods, and that's amenorrhea, and it's part of physiological amenorrhea due to pregnancy. Women who are athletes and exercise a lot, have low BMI, quite frequently have amenorrhea or absent periods due to low BMI or low weight, and same applies to women with anorexia. The treatment of menstrual disorders would depend on the cause, so we would have to establish the cause and then treat the cause of menstrual disorder. You should always see a doctor for menstrual disorder to find the cause. And if, for example, you have normally heavy periods, then one has to establish that. And at times it still has to be treated so it doesn't cause anemia or iron deficiency.